So good evening. We'll be starting today's part with transcription, translation, and translocation. But before we go ahead, I would want to give the basics for that particular concept. Now, when we talk about our body, there are specific things like, say, our height of the body or hair type, complexion of the skin, height of a plant, and types of beaks or color of the bird, etc. Now, when we talk about all of these are basically body features. And what gives us these body features? It is our DNA. Okay, so these body features, also called as biological characters, are given to us by our DNA. These body features are passed from one generation to the next, and this concept is what we call as heredity. Now, when we look into the cell, we have a nucleus and we have something called as chromatin fibers. Now, these chromatin fibers basically are the components that make our chromosomes. So, when the chromatin fiber condense, they give us chromosomes. In the year 1902, Walter Sutton and Theodore Bovary found out about these paired chromosomes in the cells of a grasshopper. Now, when we talk about chromosome, we know it is made up of DNA. DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. DNA ke chote chote segments ko hum bolte hain gene, and each gene is responsible for our body characters. So therefore we say that DNA is the genetic material. Then 1944, Oswald Avery, Maclean McCarty, Coley and McLeod found out that in all living organisms, DNA is the genetic material. Obviously there were some viruses that were an exception. Our genes give us biological characters, but how does this exactly happen? So genes have this coded message, or we can say information in a coded form, which gives chemicals, or which forms chemicals, therefore giving us our biological characteristics. Now the coded information we call as our genetic code. Genetic code ke wajah se kya hota hai? Polymerization. Polymer means many. So many amino acids come together to form our DNA. Therefore, polymerization of amino acid is going to form, therefore giving us proteins. Okay. Proteins give us our biological characteristics. When we talk about genes, we say genes gives us protein. Basically, DNA has the information for protein synthesis, and it cannot do it on its own. Therefore, RNA is required. So this theory is called as central dogma, where proteins are formed with DNA through the RNA. That is, RNA is going to be required. Now let us see the structure of DNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid. I am going to speed up a little here because this is something that we've done in 9th standard as well. So we know DNA is made up of two basic things which act as the backbone: the pentose sugar and the phosphoric acid, that is the phosphate group. DNA, we also know, is a double-stranded molecule, therefore complementary strands will be present. At the side of this strand, her sugar molecule pe you have a nitrogen base. So DNA has four nitrogen bases: adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. By Chargaff's rule, adenine will always pair with thymine, that is AT and GC. Guanine will pair with cytosine with three hydrogen bonds. So AT will be two hydrogen bonds, GC will be three hydrogen bonds. And this ladder, this structure obviously looks like a ladder and has rungs. जो हमारे steps होते हैं वैसे दिखता है, but DNA का actual structure ऐसा नहीं होता. Okay, when we talk about nucleoside and nucleotide, sugar plus nitrogen base gives us nucleoside. उसमें phosphate अगर हम add कर दे तो हमें मिलता है nucleotide. A group of three nucleotides together is called as our codon. Okay, a group of three nucleotides is called as our codon, and each codon is going to code for one amino acid. Okay, DNA के हमने देखे double strands होते हैं, this coil around each other, therefore giving us this double helical structure. Then we come to RNA, that is our ribonucleic acid. It is the second most important nucleic acid. यहाँ पर भी sugar, phosphate group and nitrogen bases हैं. बस इतना difference है that DNA double stranded था, RNA हमारा single stranded molecule है. Other than this, DNA had ATGC, RNA has AUGC. So thymine is replaced by uracil. अभी हम न्यूक्लियोटाइड समझ लिया हमने, दैट शुगर प्लस नाइट्रोजन बेस प्लस फॉस्फेट गिव्स अस अवर न्यूक्लियोटाइड. आरएनए का भी अगर हम स्मॉलेस्ट यूनिट देखें तो इट्स द न्यूक्लियोटाइड. देयरफॉर आरएनए इज कॉल्ड एज अ मैक्रो मॉलिक्यूल. नाउ ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर फंक्शंस आरएनए इज डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप्स. As I said, according to the function, RNA के तीन अलग अलग टाइप हैं. To remember this, if you take an example, a small simple story, the types and functions of RNA can very easily be remembered. So consider you go to a restaurant, you order food. That food order is taken by a waiter, given to the head chef, and the head chef asks the junior chef to bring the basic requirements for a particular dish. Okay, so considering that in a human cell, you basically are the information. Okay, waiter ne aapse information liya, head chef ko jaakar diya. Head chef ne junior chefs ko bola ke sab saman lekar aaye, and then the final product was given to you. Basically जो इंफॉर्मेशन चाहिए था वो आपको वापस मिल गई. सो हियर एज वेल द फर्स्ट टाइप कॉल्ड एज द राइबोसोमल आरएनए. सो हियर इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द राइबोसोम एज द नेम सजेस्ट्स एंड इट परफॉर्म्स द फंक्शन ऑफ प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस. मतलब ये हो गया हमारा हेड शेफ जो किचन में काम करते हैं, विच इज द राइबोसोम. Then we go to the messenger RNA. ये क्या करता है? तो हमसे information लेके head chef को देता है. Basically, it takes information from the genes, from the DNA, and it gives it to the ribosomal RNA. Now here, if you see, information is in the form of three nucleotides, जिसको हम बोलते हैं triplet codon. And the third one, which is the transfer RNA, basically the junior chefs, which bring the components required to finish the dish. So, hum already pata hai hume that proteins are made from amino acids, correct? So, ye amino acids ko lekar aane ka kaam transfer RNA karta hai. Now, transfer RNA, when I say ये अमीनो एसिड किस बेसिस पे लाएगा, तो इट विल बी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द ट्रिपलेट कोडॉन. कहां से लाएगा? तो साइटोप्लाज्म से लाएगा. और कहां पर लाएगा? तो इट इज ऑब्वियसली इन द राइबोसोम. नाउ व्हेन यू लुक एट द टीआरएनए एज वेल, इट हैज एन इंफॉर्मेशन व्हिच इज ऑपोजिट टू दैट ऑफ द एमआरएनए. देयरफॉर mRNA पे कोडॉन, tRNA पे anticodon. So, as I have given an example, to prepare a delicacy, we require three things. That is the recipe, the ingredients, and the kitchen. So here, our recipe is nothing but DNA, that is our gene. Ingredients are the amino acids, and our kitchen is the ribosome. We already know that information about protein synthesis is present in the DNA in the form of these small genes. But DNA to nucleus mein, and it cannot come out in the cytoplasm. Abhi cytoplasm mein aane ka zarurat kyun hai? Kyunki amino acids cytoplasm mein hi milenge. Yes, Hardvi, doesn't matter. Codon and triplet codon is exactly the same. Triplet codon is more specific because it is made up of three nucleotides. So it will be better if you write triplet codon. You are not giving any chance for the person to cut any marks. Okay. So as I was saying, that amino acids present hai in the cytoplasm. But DNA bahar nahi jata, therefore it requires the help of RNA. Isi cheez ko hum bolte hain central dogma. Okay. Sabse pehle kaun kaam karta hai to mRNA. Wo aayega DNA se message lega, copy karega aur usko bahar lekar jayega. So this process of copying of message from DNA to mRNA is called as transcription. I repeat, exchange of information. Okay, or copying of information from DNA to mRNA is called as transcription. Now let us understand ye hota exactly kaise hai. We have to get into the nucleus first. Nucleus mein hume pata hai hamare paas hai DNA. Aur DNA mein we are looking at a small part of the DNA. Theek hai? Now obviously agar copy karna hai, suppose you are in an exam aur aapko aage wale bache se answer copy karna hai. तो इट इज ऑब्वियस कि आगे वाले का वो पेज ओपन रहना चाहिए. सिमिलरली यहाँ पर डीएनए का जो डबल स्ट्रैंड है उसमें से कॉपी करना है तो वहां पर स्प्लिट होना इंपॉर्टेंट है. दैट इज द डीएनए हैज टू बी ओपन, ओनली देन विल द कॉपिंग स्टार्ट. सो देयरफॉर द टू स्ट्रैंड ऑफ डीएनए विल सेपरेट फ्रॉम ईच अदर गिविंग एमआरएनए द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू कॉपी एटलीस्ट वन स्ट्रैंड. Only one of the two strands are going to be used because we know mRNA is also single stranded molecule and doesn't matter kaun sa bhi strand agar copy kiya jaye, information exactly same hi hogi. Now the strand which is used for copying is called as the template strand. So if you can see in the animation, the lower strand is taken for copying mRNA. बनता जा रहा है, न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स ऐड होते जा रहे हैं. सो इफ यू कैन सी इन द एनिमेशन एमआरएनए बेसिकली न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स आर गेटिंग एडेड वन आफ्टर द अदर अकॉर्डिंग टू द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन द टेम्पलेट स्ट्रैंड. नाउ द सीक्वेंस ऑफ न्यूक्लियोटाइड इन एमआरएनए इज बीइंग प्रोड्यूस्ड. And it is always, always, always complementary. मतलब opposite होगा. अगर A है तो उसके सामने T होगा, T है उसके सामने A होगा, G, C, C, G. But again, here do not make this common mistake. अगर DNA पे T है, mRNA पे A होगा. लेकिन अगर DNA पे A है, तो mRNA पे it is going to be U. So this is something that is very common and you have to remember, do not make this mistake. Okay. Now the mRNA formed in the nucleus comes into the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm mein aata hai and it brings a coded message from the DNA. This now will code for amino acid. As I've already told, one codon codes for one amino acid. सो ईच mRNA ऐसे ही थाउजेंड्स ऑफ ट्रिपलेट कोडॉन से बना होगा, विच मीन थाउजेंड्स ऑफ अमीनो एसिड कम टूगेदर एंड फॉर्म दैट स्पेसिफिक प्रोटीन. Now the triplet codon for 20 amino acid was given by Dr. Har Gobind Khurana, for which in the year 1968 he got a Nobel Prize. Okay, students. Now in the cytoplasm, mRNA binds to the ribosome. जैसे हमारा waiter kitchen में जाकर order देता है, यहां पर mRNA which is the vector has now entered the kitchen. Okay, it will bind to the ribosome where according to the message on mRNA कौन ingredients लेकर आते थे tRNA, therefore the amino acid are going to be supplied by the tRNA. Now a common question here, okay, mRNA है ठीक है, the strand that you are looking at below is the mRNA और जो ऊपर है वो है tRNA. मतलब इतना कंफर्म हो गया कि यहाँ पर थाइमिन एज अ नाइट्रोजन बेस नहीं होगा. तो आप मुझे बताओ कि ACU जो फर्स्ट न्यूक्लियोटाइड है, जो फर्स्ट ट्रिपलेट कोडॉन है, उसका कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री सीक्वेंस, मतलब जो mRNA पे ACU है उसका कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री tRNA पे क्या होगा? आई ऑलरेडी सेड T नहीं आएगा क्योंकि दोनों RNA है. ओके, मेनी पीपल आर आंसरिंग करेक्टली. बेसिकली एड्रियन ACU का कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री मतलब उसका उल्टा आपको समझना है. एड्रियन वेट रीड द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री सीक्वेंस फॉर ए सी यू इज गोइंग टू बी ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री इज यू, सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री इज जी, यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री इज ए, सो यू जी ए एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर. कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री सीक्वेंसेस और कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री न्यूक्लियोटाइड सीक्वेंसेस विल बी ब्रॉट अबाउट बाय द tRNA. They will fix that and then they will release their amino acid. So जैसे हमने बताया mRNA पे जो है वो है कोडॉन, tRNA पे जो है वो उसका ऑपोजिट एंटी कोडॉन. Okay, so this process is called as translation. Basically the information on mRNA is now converted into information based on what amino acids are required. Therefore, translation. Continuing ahead, these amino acids that are brought about by tRNA are going to obviously be required to stay in place. If these amino acids change their sequences, protein galat form hoga, which will lead to disorders जो हमने लास्ट ईयर पढ़े हैं. सो टू कीप देम इन प्लेस दे आर बाउंडेड टुगेदर विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ पेप्टाइड बॉन्ड. सो राइबोसोमल आरएनए बेसिकली वर्क्स फॉर मेकिंग दीज पेप्टाइड बॉन्ड्स बिटवीन द टू अमीनो एसिड्स. ड्यूरिंग दिस प्रोसेस राइबोसोम कीप्स ऑन मूविंग फ्रॉम वन एंड ऑफ द mRNA टू द अदर. मतलब जैसे ही एक ट्रिपलेट कोडॉन हो गया वो मूव करेगा आगे, एक और ट्रिपलेट कोडॉन हो गया वो मूव करेगा आगे. बेसिकली व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से हियर इज mRNA इज गोइंग टू एक्ट एज द रोड एंड द राइबोसोम इटसेल्फ इज द कार. ऑब्वियसली द रोड डज नॉट गो बैक, इट इज द कार दैट मूव्स फॉरवर्ड. हियर द कार मूव्स फॉरवर्ड वंस बाय वन ट्रिपलेट कोडॉन. ओके, now this process where the ribosome is moving is called as translocation. Okay. So I hope you people have understood till here. The ribosome will move forward one triplet codon at a time, giving away many amino acids. Many such amino acids come together to form long chains of proteins, and many such polypeptide chains will give us our complex proteins. Now, starting with one evidence of evolution, which includes our connecting links. Now, as the name suggests, connecting links, it is basically going to join two different groups of animals. So, organisms referred to as connecting links are those which have structurally intermediate between two different groups, basically have characteristics of two different groups of organisms. Taking as an example, peripatus, it has some characteristics which are common to those of annelida, and some of those which are the characteristics of phylum Arthropoda. So when we talk about the characteristics of these two organisms, earthworm has segmental nephridia, which is present in the peripatus. Segmental nephridia basically are the excretory organ for organisms of annelida. Again, when we talk about the thin cuticle, that is an external outer covering which keeps the skin moist, that is also present in peripatus. And parapodia, that are locomotory organs for annelids, are also present in peripatus. So these are three characteristics which are common in both. Then we talk about arthropods. They have a trachea. They have an open circulation, which are present in peripatus. So basically, it has characteristics of both phylum annelida and arthropoda, and we cannot include it into one. Therefore, it is called as a connecting link. Similarly, when we talk about reptiles and mammals, many of you already know a platypus, duck-billed platypus. Okay. The common characteristic that matches with reptile is that it lays eggs, and it has hair and mammary glands like that in mammals. Then we talk about lungfish. Lungfish will breathe air through its lungs, although it's a fish. Basically, it can stay alive outside land for a small period of time too. So mammals have evolved from reptiles and amphibians from fishes. This is a basic example. Evidences. Okay. Now, when we talk about embryological evidences, we have compared and studied that in the initial stages of all the vertebrates, the embryos are having extreme similarities. Basically, हम अगर starting देखें evolution का, तो हम बोल सकते हैं कि ये सब के सब एक specific organism से ही evolve हुए हैं. So similarities in the initial stages indicate that these all have a common origin, जिस पे Charles Darwin has given us a lot of examples. Now Charles Darwin had given us innumerable specimens of plants and animals, and depending upon the observation of those specimens, he published a book called Theory of Natural Selection. A book titled Origin of Species, in which he preaches his own theory called as the survival of the fittest. Now, while explaining the concept, he said that all organisms reproduce prolifically, which means they give rise to young ones in large numbers. Now, all the organisms compete with each other in a life-threatening manner, and these can be for various reasons. Some might be for territory, some might be for mating, some might be for food. And in this competition, those organisms will sustain which are stronger or which have essential modifications for winning a particular competition. So, however, besides this, natural selection also plays a very important role. Now, when we look at an example that was given for Lamarckism, that there were giraffes which tried to pull their necks higher and higher and eventually did that over many generations and had a huge or a tall neck. Obviously, that was something that was wrong. What Darwin says is there must be two different species of giraffes, one with a tall neck and one with a short neck. Obviously, the tall ones survive more because competition for food for them was less. So the nature is going to select those organisms which are fit to live. And the others, that is the species of giraffe which had a short neck, perished. So sustaining and selected organisms can perform reproduction and thereby give rise to new species with their own specific characters. Matlab, jab two giraffes with a tall neck mate, or when they reproduce, they will give rise to their own kind. So Darwin's theory of natural selection was therefore widely accepted for long duration. However, there were some objections that were raised. Obviously, it is a theory. There were objections raised. So let us look at a few of those. When we talk about evolution, we cannot say that there is only one factor which is responsible for evolution. We cannot say that natural selection ek hi aisa factor hai jiske wajah se evolution hua. Agar ye nahi hota to evolution hota hi. So that is something that is wrong. Other than that, Darwin also could not explain about the useful and useless modification. Like our thumb, the opposable thumb is something that is very useful. So ye kyun hua? जो हमारा ईयर पिन्ना है, नॉट रिक्वायर्ड बट वो अभी भी है, तो ये क्यों है? दीज थिंग्स डार्विन कुड नॉट एक्सप्लेन. अलोंग विद दैट, देयर इज नो एक्सप्लेनेशन अबाउट द स्लो एंड अब्रप्ट चेंजेस. नाउ समटाइम्स यू कैन सी दैट इन बर्ड्स देयर आर सर्टेन मॉडिफिकेशंस जो एक ही रीजन में होते हैं. नाउ सम ऑफ देम माइट हैव मॉडिफाइड बिकॉज ऑफ slow changes over a period of many years, but there might be some jahan par mutation hua or sudden changes aaye. So that Darwin could not explain. Irrespective of all of these objections, Darwin's work on evolution has been a milestone. So theory of natural selection, Darwin also done. Now we talk about speciation. Now, formation of new species of plants and animals is the effect of evolution. Now, species basically kya hota hai? So it is a group of organisms that can produce organisms like them, which can further go on with natural reproduction. Basically, dogs will produce dogs, which will grow up, reproduce, and produce dogs. So, वो अपना generation को continue करते हैं. ऐसे organisms को हम बोलते हैं one species of organisms. Now, each species grows in specific geographical conditions. Some of them extremely cold conditions. Some of them in hot conditions, some of them in water, be it salt water, fresh water, etc. So har ek organism ka food, unka rehne ka jagah, unka reproductive ability, and for how long they survive, all of this is going to be different. However, genetic variation is responsible for formation of new species. Now genetic variation is some mutation in a gene is going to give those changes or make those changes in the further generations. Iske alawa, geographical or reproductive changes bhi responsible hai for giving out two different species from one particular species of organism. For example, अब this is a species of bugs, okay? पहले ये सब पूरे एरिया में एक ही नया एक ही स्पीशीज था, बट बिकॉज ऑफ अ ज्योग्राफिकल बैरियर, जैसे एक वॉटर बॉडी स्टार्टेड रनिंग बिटवीन दीज टू फॉरेस्ट, देयरफॉर स्प्लिटिंग इट. नाउ बिकॉज ऑफ ज्योग्राफिकल आइसोलेशन एंड सम चेंजेस इन देयर वेदर क्लाइमेट व्हाटएवर, सम बेसिक चेंजेस जो हुए उसके वजह से टू मेंबर्स वर स्प्लिट. बेसिकली the species got isolated. Therefore, now they are unable to interbreed. जो left side पे रह गए उनका अपना अलग isolation हो गया, right side पे उनका अलग isolation हो गया. They cannot reproduce. Therefore, reproductive isolation occurred. This will lead to formation of two different species, one on the left, one on the right. ऐसा ही एक example है squirrel का भी, Malabar squirrel and the Himalayan squirrel, which you can understand. Okay, basically because of the formation of mountain, one species of squirrel got divided into two different types.